Good morning. It is July 14th, which means it's been an entire year since I had double jaw surgery. I'm gonna go through and talk about what this year has been like, how long things took, what I thought went well, what I thought just was like just hard to manage, and then show a little bit of before and after pictures because everybody loves those. So go ahead and watch if you want. See how, if yours is lining up. Everyone's different, so don't worry if we're in different stages, but just to kind of see what it could be like for you after 1 year of your jaw surgery. So yeah, can't believe it's been a year. Here are some 1 year exactly before and after pictures for you. So in terms of ortho, because all of you will either be like midway through your ortho treatment or going through your pre-surgery ortho treatment or anything like that. So my last ever appointment is July 26th. I'm just getting them to do the last kind of check and then they're gonna take pictures and then that'll be it, which is so crazy. This is how my teeth have turned out. Lined up. Everything straight, bites touching, just everything I've ever wanted and everything I didn't even know I wanted have come together, and it has been a process. Like, I will not sugarcoat that, but I can't complain. They're perfect. You can't even see my gums when I smile. It's just everything that I didn't even realize has come true. So if you're mid through or you're just starting it, I know it's gonna seem like a while, but trust me, it is so worth it. Just get through it, put your head down, and just grind your way through it. Like, it will be so worth it in the end. I promise. I had to wear those buttons that you see in my previous videos for a while. I got the actual buttons removed at like 6 weeks post jaw surgery, except for a few up top and on the bottom in the back, so not too visible. Those were for elastics, which I had to wear pretty much until like a month or two ago, just to really solidify like your back molars and all that jazz. So if you do get buttons like I did, beware that you will have those for quite a long time. And if you have the choice, get the clear ones because they are less visible. I had the metal ones on the bottom, but as you can see, like I was able to hide them better, but definitely the top ones get clear because you're gonna have those for a while. Oh, here's one of my dogs. Food wise, so this was tricky. I was using a straw and eating mostly like liquids and mushy stuff till literally like 6 weeks. Well, aside from like mushy mac and cheese or like really, really soft pasta and stuff. But yeah, in terms of like when I was able to like eat a Subway or something or a burger, like that was definitely after I moved back to school. So if I got my surgery July 14th, probably around like October, I would say I was able to really like get in there, use my jaw muscles and bite down through like a tomato or something. And that's just me. I took a really long time to heal. Everybody's different. Like, some people you're literally back to eating mostly solid foods by 6 weeks. So, or not most people, but some. So yeah, I don't know. It was like, it was very tricky. I'll show you some videos and, or some photos of me. And I was very swollen. It took a long time. I'm still waiting for just a bit, the last little bit of swelling to go down, just kind of here, and then sometimes just like around there, and then a bit in my jaw still. Not crazy, like it's basically gone, but it is pretty early in the morning, and first thing in the morning when I wake up, it gets like a bit thicker, and then by the end of the day, it's basically gone. So it's just how I sleep and how it kind of is at night. But yeah, it was, I don't know, the best thing I found. I used to love chips, and I definitely really don't eat chips that often anymore. I couldn't eat chips for a long time, and I just kind of, like, I stopped wanting them anymore. Now, like, I just, like, I don't really enjoy it. I love ice cream. That was the biggest savior, for sure. Yeah, yogurts, cottage cheese, smoothies, all that jazz was really helpful. I did lose about 10 pounds, but I gained it back really quick. Like, I'm an athlete. I didn't really have too many issues with that, but you really do need to make sure that you're, if you do end up losing weight, it's a healthy amount, and that you are following the liquid diet as you have to, but it's not the reason you're losing weight. You know, so I don't know, it was tricky, but I did find my way after a while, for sure. Okay, so swelling wise, I didn't find anything like helped a lot. I was very swollen, but some things I tried to use that like kind of helped-ish were like a gua sha. Those were awesome. On Amazon, just with the rolling one and then the like actual gua sha. And then I had this like roller ice pack that my cousin gave me, and it was phenomenal. Oh my god, like it's frozen, just roll it. Like the roller you would get on Amazon, just bigger when you can put it in the freezer. That was so great for waking up in the morning, just getting that refresh and trying to calm the swelling down right away. And then heating packs, as I said in my previous videos, were really helpful with swelling. Once you get after the initial like pain of the jaw surgery after like week one and two, ice isn't really beneficial anymore. It feels good, but doesn't really do much. So using the heating pack just really just helps flush the swelling and stuff. And yeah, Advil, stay on top of your meds. If you leave it till it starts to hurt, that's just stupid. Like, don't do that. Stay on top of it. Be consistent. And yeah, get your face moving. The more you move it, the quicker you'll be able to start feeling it and hopefully start getting some of that swelling flushed out. So some of the issues that were really hard to deal with were, one of them that I mentioned in one of my previous videos was that I got really sick the first couple nights I was home. That's really rare, like it probably won't happen to you. But yeah, I got really sick, really dehydrated, couldn't keep anything down, including my meds, so I was not on any pain meds for a few days, so it was horrible. But once I was able to get some really high quality gravel, was starting to keep things down and started getting better from there, so I didn't have to go to the hospital, which was good. And then after that, the swelling was really, really challenging. I was really swollen for upwards of 9 months after my jaw surgery. After 9 months, it kind of started to get a little bit better, but yeah, it was just very hard just on my confidence and kind of your identity, looking in the mirror and kind of seeing what you're gonna look like and really just trying to put it on pause and be like, I am not gonna look like this for the rest of my life. Like, don't worry. Just hang in there and keep doing what you're doing and it will get there eventually. Yeah, those are, I think, just the two main things that I struggled with a lot. Eating was tough, but I knew one day I'd be able to eat a burger and stuff again, so I really wasn't too worried about that. Those were kind of just the two. And now, like, I am much more confident with looking at myself in the mirror, and, like, I still kind of have that a little bit, just some mornings. Like, I'm a little swollen this morning, but not really compared at all to what I was, but so I still struggle with that a little bit. But other than that, I if those are the only two things, and I don't think those two things were so important that I wouldn't choose to do jaw surgery again, if that makes sense. Another question I get asked a lot is like about work, like how you would take time off for work and stuff. I was just serving in the summer because I had it during the summer, and I was moving back to school at the end of August anyway, so I just took the 6 weeks off of work, mostly just because, like, with the swollen face and stuff, like, it was just, serving's pretty, like, face-to-face interactions and stuff, so I just really wasn't comfortable with that. But I would say, like, 2 to 3 weeks, maybe 4, if you don't have a job, if you have a job that you're, like, comfortable going back in with maybe that bit of swelling still, you're able to do it. Mine's just, like, was in the heat, with my swelling, I just really wasn't comfortable. But by the time I got back into school, I was able to start working right away. So honestly, just personal preference. And obviously, if it's your full-time job and you need to get back in there, then you just, again, talk with your doctor, talk with your employer and stuff. But that's how I went about it. I was lucky enough to do this while I'm only working summer jobs and then my part-time job while I'm in school. So it's kind of why I did it so early on, so I don't have to balance it with a full-time job. But yeah, that was also my experience. Again, this is just my side. It'll depend completely on the person getting the jaw surgery and their experience. I just want to share my point of view so you can go from there and figure out what works best for you. Okay, so working out wise, I went on my first run like 5 weeks after jaw surgery, and then by the time I was able to like work out for real, like full out, it was like 6 months-ish. And I know that sounds long, but like I was so swollen. I was just dealing with making sure that me exerting while I was exercising wasn't causing more swelling, where it would like be harder to help it go. But it depends on every person. That's just individually how mine went. I didn't want to push myself too crazy. Yeah, so you and your doctor have to decide what's best for you. That's just personal. That's just my experience. Essentials you need: syringes, big and small. The long ones with the like extender straws are phenomenal for getting through your wires. You need that face, the ice pack roller that my cousin got me. Saved my life. Like, best thing we had for sure. The Gua Sha rollers you can get on Amazon. The face ice packs, like I ended up literally putting frozen peas with a tensor bandage wrapped around. It looked hilarious and it was stupid, but like that was the best one that I had, so highly recommend those. As like just like right like a week after, I would say that was the best, oh my god, for sleeping, like and then the heating pack, 1000%. If you could get one that's like a plug-in, then you don't have to like have someone or even you keep getting up to reheat it. Tylenol, keep on your pain meds, as I said. Oh, Pedialyte for the first week to help you be really hydrated is awesome. Gravol, ginger ale, just that kind of stuff to help you try to feel a little better. Noodle soup, trying like all different types of soups so you don't get too like grossed out of trying to eat like the same two ones every time. And then be creative, like just try different smoothies, different things to just not get tired of the liquids so fast. Like protein shakes, keep up the protein. Like I noticed the first thing I lost was my muscle, like, which was hard to gain back. But just like keep be creative so that you don't get sick of stuff right away, because if you start getting sick of stuff like a week or so in, like I'm sorry to tell you, but it's gonna be a long road. Like you gotta be creative. And yeah, like don't watch cooking shows. I did that and then that was silly because I was like, oh my god, burger would be so good, knowing I couldn't have one for like 4 months. So I don't know, eventually like after 6 weeks when you can start like trying to chew, like you can cut stuff up really small and try that. But yeah, I don't know, be creative, have support, Pedialyte, all that stuff I listed, That's what you need. Trust me. Yeah.
Last but not least, shout out to my mom, my dad, my sisters, and even my dogs, and my extended family who all supported me like crazy. Could not done this without them. From getting me ice packs to just being there to let me complain and whine and say I'm sore. Every little thing, they were phenomenal. I couldn't have done this without them. I love them. Thank you guys. You are just the best and I love you all so much. Thank you for watching. You should like and subscribe and comment anything else that you would add for people watching and going through the same thing that I may have missed from your own personal experience and anything. Like, I just want to help because I watched so many of your guys' videos and you all helped me so much, so I just wanted to share my experience because it's just such a unique thing we're all going through. So thank you for watching. Good luck if you're getting the surgery soon. Keep going if you just got the surgery, and if you're about to hit a year just like I am, congratulations, we did it, and it's just gonna keep getting better from here. Thanks for watching, guys.